have two board now. This is the Arduino Uno and this is the NodeMCU V3 or Lolin. So as we know, if we usually use this board Arduino Uno, this is so popular because this is so simple and have enough pin for us to use. And this is the NodeMCU that today we will try to use this. Okay. So what's the difference between the Arduino Uno and the NodeMCU? So the big deal is that the Arduino Uno didn't have the Wi-Fi control like this board. So this board has the built-in Wi-Fi control. So if you want to build project like Internet of Things or something that send the data to the internet, you will easier to use this, and this board is so much faster than this old one. But if you don't want to build Internet of Things, you will think that the Arduino Uno is actually so much easier because this is already have so much tutorials resource on the internet. So I think this board will compatible with almost every sensor and have so many ready to use library and demo code. So this is so much better if you not will use the internet. Okay, so what make this better actually? So we can see the pin out, the different pin out between this and this. The Arduino, as we know, has 14 digital I/O and has 6 analog input. Okay, so the analog input is more in the Arduino Uno. When at this board, we just have one analog input, so it's just have one analog input. But as you see at the picture, we have 16 digital I/O, so this can derive more digital actuator, you know, and have two serial. But you have to think that not every library will compatible with this board. Okay, so let's get start to program this board, the NodeMCU. Okay, we can start by open the Arduino IDE. If you already installed the Arduino IDE, at first you can't find any NodeMCU board like this, just like this. So you need to install the board first. You have to open the file preferences and use the link. Add the additional board manager URLs. So I will paste the URL here. You can use this URL to add the board at board manager. Okay, and then we can open tools, board, and click the board manager. Then search for ESP. Okay, and then you can find the ESP H260 by ESP H266 community. So you can just click install. Okay, now it's complete. So you can close this tool and then we can choose our board. So we have to choose the NodeMCU 1.0. Click. And now we can start plug the USB cable to the board. Then we can open the tool port and it's already detected on COM5. So now we can start code anything. We can open example basic like the bling. Okay, so this is the bling example from the Arduino sample. We now will test the simple sketch if this work in our NodeMCU. So we have to edit the pin because the NodeMCU built-in LED is mapped to pin 2. And upload. Okay, it's done uploading and we can see the yellow LED is blinking. This means that the board works and our program works. Okay, I think that is our tutorial about getting started with NodeMCU. So, see you at next NodeMCU tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell so you will not miss our tutorial. Bye bye.